Hi guys, and today we have a very special guest, Dr. Priyanka, a homeopathic physician from Government Homeopathic Medical College, Bangalore. Thanks for joining.
Thank you, Shivam. Thank you for having me over.
So today we will have a conversation with Dr. Priyanka about her college. So let's begin. Firstly, how is your college different from the other BHMS colleges in Karnataka?
See, Government Homeopathic Medical College is the only government institution in the state of Karnataka, and there are other, including Government Homeopathic Medical College, we have 12 colleges in the whole state. And GHMC is affiliated to Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, and it is recognized by the Central Council of Homeopathy. GHMC ranks one of the best homeopathy colleges in Karnataka. So this college has a student intake of 100 students per year for undergraduate course, and it has 28 seats for MD each year. So the subjects offered for MD are practice of medicine, pediatrics, the materia medica, organon of medicine, and the repertory. So currently we have 5 subjects for masters and 28 seats.
Okay, so could you please elaborate about the course curriculum, the BHMS entire course curriculum in your college?
Yeah, see, the curriculum was revised in 2015. That's when ABAD joined the college, and it came into effect the same year. And it is approved by the Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences and recognized by the Central Council of Homeopathy. So what they did was a group of professors and head of the departments, the HODs of each subject, they were appointed for this purpose. And even professors from different colleges of the state were appointed. So they formed a revised syllabus, and they jotted down the topics into 3 headings. So the first one being the must-know topics, the desirable-to-know topics, and the nice-to-know topics. So this pattern of syllabus became very convenient for the teachers to teach, and even for the students to understand and learn. Like, if you take one subject, there you have lot of topics to be studied under every part of the body. So if you take anatomy, you have the head and neck, then you have the upper limbs, the chest and thorax, then the lower limbs. So every part has one, like there are so many bones in the body, so many nerves, so many muscles and veins, arteries, veins. There's everything which needs to be studied, and it is important that a medical student has to know it because that is the structure of the body. So when everything was there, the students were literally like, it was very confusing ki, like what to study, what not to study, how to study. There was no pattern as such. So when this syllabus was formed, the topics were noted down under desirable to know, must know, and nice to know. In this way, every topic was studied in each subject. Nothing was left out. So everything was covered. And it is a very student-friendly syllabus. We have followed it for 4.5 years, and it's very good.
Definitely it is. So now I'll ask a few specific points about your college. So firstly, how's the faculty there?
The faculty here is amazing. You learn so much from your professors, both on a personal and a professional note. They are very friendly and helpful. They'll guide us. They'll let us fall and fail, learn from our mistakes, and yet at the same time, they'll be there to correct you. Like, they're always there to tell you what to do, what not to do, and how it has to be done. Clinical skills are taught, bedside, we are taught what to do, what not to do. They are always there, very friendly. You can just count on them for whatever doubt you have or whatever help you need. And I've got to learn from the best teachers, I must say. And this, in a way, I think I feel like I'm giving back to my teachers. I'll forever be grateful because this 5.5 years of my life, this has made me for what I am today. I think that has made me what I am today. So I'll always be grateful to my teachers.
So, please tell me about the campus of your college.
The college has its own campus with the hospital campus separately. So the college campus has subject departments with laboratories for students, a beautiful auditorium named as Dr. Kent Auditorium, a college library along with the digital library, and the hospital has a capacity of accommodating 100 patients. with all the modern facilities for diagnostics, like a well-equipped pathology lab, an X-ray room, an ultrasound, yoga, and even physiotherapy. So even physiotherapy is provided to the patients in Government Homeopathic Medical Hospital. And there are well-qualified professionals to manage these facilities. And now the hospital has also started specialty OPDs in cancer, rheumatology, lifestyle diseases, dermatology, and pediatrics.
So could you please tell me about the patient load here?
See, the hospital OPD, that is the outpatient department, has a daily average of 450 to 500 patients, while the IPD, that is the inpatient department, has 40 to 50 patients on a daily basis.
Okay. So, lastly, something which the juniors will always fear about is that the atmosphere there, how are the seniors? So, could you please elaborate about that?
Yeah, seniors are very friendly and helpful. One can count on their seniors for any doubt or help whenever needed. So I have been a senior to my juniors, so we have helped. There's a friendly relationship between the seniors and the juniors. It's a very friendly and helpful relationship.
Definitely. And one last question would be that what is your advice for the juniors who will be watching this video and thinking about pursuing BHMS at your college?
Okay. See guys, Government Homeopathic Medical College is one of the best colleges in Karnataka, and along with the academic knowledge and opportunities, one will get a very good hold of clinical skills and experiences. Like I said, there is a OPD strength is 400 to 500 on a daily basis, and patients, that is inpatient department, has 40 to 50 patients. So you know, students are taught bedside manners and bedside examination of the patient from the second year itself. So you have a good clinical exposure. It's not just sitting in a classroom and studying all the time. You can actually go to the hospital, see patients, examine, take cases, learn. Clinical exposure is given right from second year itself. And pursuing medicine is all about hard work, dedication, and patience. No matter whichever stream of medicine you choose, just give your best. And homeopathy it's the best, and you can just flourish in the system.
Definitely, definitely. So that's the end to this wonderful conversation. I hope the audience got an idea about the college review of Government Homeopathic Medical College, Bangalore. So thank you, Dr. Priyanka, for this lovely interview.
Yeah. Thank you, Shivam.